We've got Arkham Moto's Mark Frohnmayer. Hey, Mark.
Neil, how are you, sir?
I'm good, man. How are you doing?
I'm great. I really enjoyed the Kevin O'Leary life pro tips. That was fantastic.
Yeah, he's got a lot of advice for a lot of people. That is for sure. You are rocking the Yggdrasil tapestry. I'm always happy to see it. Such a great background selection. What do you got in store for us today?
Well, you should have a slide deck there. And we're going to start with just the overview video of Arkham Moto. And then I'll run through some slides. And if I run through them fast enough, then we'll have a few minutes for a Q&A. How's that sound?
Sounds good. Just make sure to breathe.
Yes. All right.
Arkham Moto. We build rides. Light, electric, ultra-efficient rides that are outrageously fun to drive. Because getting this with this is nuts. We build Arkham Motos for people and for delivery and for people who help people. We're a public company because we have a public mission and we invite you to join us. I'm Mark. In 2007, I went looking for something that didn't exist. Because then and now, we drive crazy big, multi-ton extractive rigs for all the simple trips. Times everyone, we pave over half the city, gridlocked, around a world on fire. I wanted a light footprint electric vehicle, affordable, fun, and dialed for the everyday. I couldn't find it, and thus, Arkham Moto, and a new platform for mobility. Twin electric motor front-wheel drive with a burly battery and a powertrain that sips electrons. We launched production of our flagship product, the Fun Utility Vehicle, in 2019. And from the response, we believe it lives up to the name.
This is really fun! Oh my god! It's yay! Woo! Oh my god, this is so fun!
Very cool. And wow, does it handle?
Everybody wants it when they see it. And they haven't even driven it yet. The real joy is when you get to drive it. And then you just get the feeling of what it's all about.
Hey, Mark, what's up, buddy? Just want to let you know how much I am enjoying my amazing Arkham Moto. It is an absolute blast. People chasing me down in the neighborhood to see it.
Let me guess, you want one?
I'm going to buy shares.
Right on.
At the onset of the pandemic, we launched the Deliverator to bring the benefits of Arkham Moto's platform to last mile delivery of essential food and goods. The Deliverator's spacious storage suits a wide variety of fleet uses. Its svelte form maneuvers through traffic with ease and parks in spaces no full-size vehicle can. Saving fleet operators precious time means money that flows directly to the bottom line. And we launched the Rapid Responder to help those on the front lines achieve their missions more quickly.
I think that the Arkham Moto is the perfect vehicle to implement in our city. It's lighter, it's more efficient, it's quicker. There's the cost savings that are associated with it in terms of sustainability, maintenance. I see this as a daily deployed apparatus. How come the cops aren't using one of these?
Finally, we announced the Roadster, Arkham Moto's premium entry into the established class of pure on-road fun machines. We sell direct. Arkham Moto adopters place pre-orders and configure options on the website, and vehicles are delivered directly to our customers. The curious can enjoy the Arkham Moto driving experience at our rental centers. Our rental-first model turns what is normally a costly hurdle to brand awareness into a revenue stream. Every Arkham Moto is built here at our factory in Oregon, the AMP, where we transform raw material through part cutting, forming, welding, machining, and final assembly, all under one roof. With the growing demand for alternative personal transportation around the world, highlighted by our thousands of FUV pre-orders, the seismic shift towards home delivery of food and goods, and over 50,000 fire stations in North America alone, we believe Arkham Moto is poised for expansive growth. Meeting this demand through mass production is now our primary goal. To that end, we've entered into an agreement to purchase a new facility that will increase our manufacturing footprint more than fivefold. And we've teamed with industry legends to refine our platform and product family for volume at a price that is affordable to the wide market. We aim to prove our model can scale and this venture can go global. Arkham Moto is and always has been powered by a community of stakeholders with whom we share a vision of sustainable transportation, clean skies, and a future that's a whole lot more fun. We hope you'll join us.
So that's the 4 minute version of the Arcimoto story. I'm going to go into a little bit more detail. So the brand Arcimoto means future I drive. It's the brand identity for the next generation of drivers. And this image I find personally very powerful because it really highlights the disconnect between cars and how we actually use cars every day. And it's that overcapacity of cars, whether they're electric or not, that leads to congestion and the fact that we dedicate like half of our urban landscape to asphalt for moving and parking cars. And so if we are to meet the goals that we must meet in order to deal with the climate crisis that's right upon us, we need more than just the electrification of old ideas of transportation. And that's where we see the real opportunity in electric vehicles is in the gap between the bike and the car. And that's the gap that we have been going after since Arcimoto's founding in 2007. Since this is a track on disruptive innovation, a little refresher on disruption theory, the idea of a sort of canonical disruptor is a product or service that meets the utility threshold of a market, but does so at a much lower cost. And so when you think about the Arcimoto sort of platform one vision, it is to deliver a product that falls into the price range of a golf cart or a toy or a side-by-side ATV, but delivers on the utility needs of the vast majority of everyday trips. So instead of shooting for the price of a new car, we're shooting for the price of a used car, really where the bulk of the vehicle market is. One of our analysts calls this many shots or multiple shots on goal. It is, we've honed it's our eighth generation vehicle platform design, and it is both incredibly efficient and incredibly flexible for a wide range of everyday trips. And you could see in the video several of the different products that we've built that are sort of bespoke for different market verticals. Where all of this goes with Platform One is the concept of personal mass transit. So I really see Arcimoto as being at the confluence of every trend in the future of mobility: lightweight, ultra-efficient, electric vehicles connected and available at the touch of a button by either autonomous drive or remote operation. And it's that model of autonomy where you're really using the autonomous systems and the drive-by-wire systems to bring a vehicle to a driver. That's a much lower bar to cross than the sort of full level five autonomy robo-taxi thing that many people say is still years and years away. We think that the marrying of a readily available autonomous technology today has the opportunity to dramatically reduce the cost of operation of a shared vehicle network. And when that's paired with a vehicle platform that is already incredibly affordable, we think this provides the opportunity for a big, big win in transportation. This is kind of the big picture vision of our first platform, which is ultimately transforming parking lots into parks, reclaiming lane miles of asphalt, and making cities not suck anymore. We're also developing another platform. And this is because, again, Arcimoto is really all about the gap between the bike and the car. And so we see another opportunity for a whole new order of magnitude of improvement in terms of efficiency, cost, weight, materials with a whole new line of vehicles. And this is the reason why we acquired Tilting Motorworks at the beginning of this year. The e-bike marketplace has experienced massive year-over-year growth, like I want to say 140% 2019 to 2020. And we see the opportunity to build a truly groundbreaking product in that micromobility space. So where Arcimoto's Platform 1 target is 1,000 pounds. We think the Arcimoto Platform 2 product is going to land, you know, yet another, almost an order of magnitude, lighter weight, lower cost, more efficient. And again, to solve the kinds of typical trips that we do on an everyday basis. So 2021, this year, is all about building the foundation for the next decade of Arcimoto's growth. I'm going to run through our top level goals and then open it up to Q&A. So this year we plan to articulate our full Platform One product family, all of the different variants of our Platform One family. We plan to introduce our first Platform Two product. So stay tuned. We believe that Arcimoto, that there are a number of different shared Arcimoto business models that are worth exploring. And this is runs from vehicle sharing programs to destination rentals. And so opening up rental centers in key destinations is going to be another major push this year. We just had our soft opening of our San Diego center last Friday, and we'll be starting up rentals from that center imminently. Another goal is to demonstrate the autonomously driven Arcimoto. And that's this is a program that is actively in the works presently, and we're very excited about it. We're presently only selling Arcimotos to customers in four states, Washington, Oregon, California, and Florida. So we plan to expand our footprint of sales during the course of this year and into 2022. And then another major goal for the year is the acquisition of scale production financing. We're targeting the Advanced Technology Vehicle Manufacturing Loan Program. We're very encouraged by what the Biden administration has said about its targets for carbon emission reduction, growing employment here in the United States to tackle these problems. We planned, as I mentioned in the video, we have actually now purchased a new facility for expansion of production. And it is going to be a significant project to turn that into a next generation Arcimoto manufacturing plant. We call this the ramped Arcimoto manufacturing plant. We will be doing some small amount of production work out of this facility in this year. And then we are targeting quarter four of 2022 for the real start of production off of the assembly line in the ramp facility. And this is going to be we're looking at this as our prototype for global scale. So we're building the microprocessor core, if you will, of mass production that we intend to replicate ultimately all over the world. We are producing vehicles now in our current facility. So the AMP is up and running. We've delivered now more than a couple of hundred vehicles as of the end of Q1 to customers. We plan to deliver 500 customers vehicles this year. And in addition to that, I mean, really the probably the most important thing that we are doing this year from a production standpoint is getting vehicles out for demonstration and rental purposes into the market to drive the experience of the brand, awareness of the brand, and ultimately fill the sales pipeline that fills that mass production facility in 2023 and beyond. And the key goal is to get butts in seats. This is true of electric vehicles generally. This is, any electric car company, the real goal is to get somebody in the driver's seat to experience just what a great experience the electric vehicle is. And what we have found is that the experience of the Arcimoto is really compelling for people. It is often surprising. People express surprise saying things like, I've never had this much fun in a vehicle. This was much more than I thought it was going to be. And so we think that direct experience of the product is really important. It's one of the advantages I think that we have actually being having a production vehicle on the road now is that we can actually get people into seats. Now, we've been basically off the road for almost the whole duration of the pandemic. Now that the team is vaccinated, we are feeling much more comfortable getting out on tour. We're going to be running simultaneous tours on the East and West coasts. And then of course we're opening facilities that will be doing continuous rentals and demonstrations throughout our initial target markets. So that's the big Arcimoto story. And with that, I'm going to go ahead and stop the share and we can open it up for questions.
All right. We have a lively conversation going on in chat. Guys, what questions? We've got FUV here. What types of questions do we have here? The number one question, let's go ahead and get it out of the way for those that are not participating in chat. Can you take one of these on the highway?
Yes. Yeah. The Arcimoto is it's a motorcycle class vehicle. Three wheelers are motorcycles. And it can go on all the roads. Top speed is 75 miles an hour. Zero to fun immediately. Infinite smiles per gallon.
Beautiful. Beautifully stated. Legitimate stats. And then what about flooding or heavy rain?
So if you go to arcimoto.com/allweather, there's a video of Fubbin in the rain. You know, we're here in Eugene, Oregon is where we're headquartered, where we get, I think, 160 days of rain a year or something crazy like that. And it is surprising how well even the open configuration of the Arcimoto keeps you dry in the rain. That said, there are areas, you know, when it's coming in sideways, you want to have some kind of a shelled enclosure. And we've got our half doors are through the production testing process, and those will be available, I think, in Q3. We have full side enclosures that are available as well. The open model really is part of that being in the world that really makes the ride experience so compelling, so that you can see exactly where you are on the road. You can see your wheels. You're sort of like a part of the world when you're driving an Arcimoto. But we think, you know, certainly as we approach, sort of true mass production, it's going to be really important to be able to serve as many climate regions as we possibly can. So that's in the plans.
Beautiful. And speaking of production, when will that new assembly plant become operational?
So we're targeting Q4 of 2022, okay. Basically end of next year. That we've assembled really a rock star team to tackle the scale planning for the company. Principally Monroe and Associates, but then we've brought in a number of other folks to help with other key pieces of the project.
Okay. And platform two, when will that be revealed?
We have not announced a date of that reveal. That's
it's a good time to do it.
What's that? But we're doing it this we will show it this year.
Okay.
And again, that is a longer range. I don't expect to see production version of that that product until, you know, earliest would be late 2022.
Okay. And then global sales, what does the roadmap look like for that?
Well, we just hired we expanded our exec team by two this year. One is with the acquisition of Tilting Motor Works, Bob Mile, the founder, became our chief tilting officer and is really driving the platform two equation. And then we brought on Dilip Sundaram, who was a senior executive at Mahindra, overseeing a number of different really key programs for their global processes. He is tasked with really building out, you know, we get inquiries and pre-orders literally from all over the planet, and people saying, you know, this vehicle would be perfect in India, in Ghana, in Europe, in South America. And it is true in the sense that the vehicle usage patterns all over the world, and particularly in places that are dense, crowded, small roads, that's what the Arcimoto platform is designed to rock. So what Dilip is putting together is, you know, where are the big opportunities? Where are the low bars for getting into market? What are the right partnerships in order to initially, you know, export vehicles? And ultimately, where are the places that we want to build Arcimoto product family vehicles all over the planet?
Beautiful. And when are you sending that model we talked about to the Benzinga headquarters in Detroit?
That will be coming soon. We got to get you in the driver's seat.
Okay, excellent. Thank you so much, Mark. You have been fantastic. Any final remarks for our retail investors and institutional investors here today?
Well, I think we're in a really interesting time in the electric vehicle, electric vehicle market growth. I would just encourage folks to really think about, the next time you jump in your car by yourself, think about all the empty seats that you're carrying around. I mean, if you had a balance scale, I'm on a good day, 200 pounds. A car is 20 times my weight, and it's really crazy that we all use those things by ourselves or with just one other person for all the simple trips. And that's what Arcimoto is really all about, is not just electrification is necessary but not sufficient to solve the real problem. It's time to really rethink the patterns of mobility and the shift to electric drive and the shift to autonomy. That's the perfect time to do it.
Beautiful. All right. Thank you so much for being with us today, Mark.
Thanks, Neil.